Assalamu alaikum. Welcome all to Easy Human Anatomy channel. In this video, I discuss the tract of gracilis and cunnilinus. This is an ascending tract of somatosensory pathways. At first, what is tract? Tract is a collection of the axon within the central nervous system, and collection of the axon outside the central nervous system is known as the nerve. So this is nerve, this is tract. Tract are two types, ascending tract and descending tract. Descending tract carry motor order from the motor cortex of the cerebrum toward the effector organ, for example skeletal muscle. The ascending tract is the sensory information is first received by the receptor, and by the using three set of neurons, this sensory information is reached the sensory cortex of the cerebrum. So some basic point regarding ascending tract, receptor, sensory cortex of the cerebrum and three sets of neurons. So this is the receptor which receives the sensory information, and via this first order, second order, third order neuron, this sensory information is reached the sensory cortex. This is the pseudonuclear neuron, or functionally this is sensory neuron. It has single nerve process which is divided into two. This is the peripheral process, this is the central process. The terminal portion of the peripheral process is converted into receptor, and so receptor first receives the sensory information, then peripheral process, then sensation is goes through the central process. The axon of the central process is synapse with the second order neuron. This is the axon of the second order neuron which synapse with the third order neuron. This is the axon of the third order neuron which terminate into the sensory cortex. So this is the cross section of the spinal cord. This is the H-shaped inner gray matter, outer white matter. This is the ventral horn, this is the dorsal horn. Just middle to the dorsal horn, this is the location of tract of gracilis and cunnilinus. What type of sensation carried by the tract of gracilis and cunnilinus? Discriminative touch, vibration, conscious muscle and joint sensation. This sensation is carried by the special type of receptor, Meissner corpuscle, Pacinian corpuscle, muscle, pintle and tendon organ. The first order neuron. Like other sensory pathways, the first order neuron is posterior root ganglia. So this is the pseudonuclear neuron, this is the single process, this is the peripheral process. The terminal portion of the peripheral process is converted into receptor. This is the central process which enter within the spinal cord. This is the second motor neuron, nucleus gracilis and nucleus cunnilinus, which is located in the lower medulla oblongata. So this is the central process of the first motor neuron. There is some difference between other sensory tract and tract of gracilis, because when the axon of the first motor neuron is synapse with the second order neuron, and the axon of the second order neuron cross and goes to the opposite side of the spinal cord. But you see here the central process of the first order neuron is remain in the same site. Then it synapses with the second order neuron which is located in the same site at the lower part of the medulla oblongata. The axon of the second order neuron is cross and goes to the opposite side of the medulla oblongata. The third order neuron. Like other sensory pathway, the axon of the second order neuron is synapse with the third order neuron, and the location of the third order neuron is the ventral posterior lateral nuclei of the thalamus. You see, thalamus is a small collection of the nerve cell body within the white matter of the cerebrum. The other sensory pathway, lateral and anterior spinothalamic tract formed spinal lemniscus, but tract of gracilis and cunnilinus is not formed spinal lemniscus. Tract of gracilis and cunnilinus form the medial lemniscus when by the axon of the second motor neuron, which is cross and goes to the opposite side of the brainstem. So this is the medial lemniscus. So final destination is like other sensory tract, the postcentral gyrus, the sensory cortex of the cerebrum 312. So what the lesions of the tract of gracilis and cunctatus? Lesion always ipsilateral, but in case other sensory tract, the lesion is contralateral. So what type of loss occur in lesion of the tract of gracilis and cunctatus? Ipsilateral loss of muscle and joint sensation, 2-point dyskinemission, vibration below the level of the lesion, but sensation of the touch is unaffected, movement are jerky and ataxic. So there is a basic difference. The first order and third order neurons same in both sensory pathway, but for lateral spinothalamic tract and anterior spinothalamic tract, the second order neuron is located within the substantia gyrus, which is located in the dorsal horn of the spinal cord. But the location of the second order neuron in case of tract of gracilis and cunctatus is the lower part of the medulla oblongata. And these two tract from spinal lemniscus and tract of gracilis and cunctatus from the medial lemniscus. So these are the basic difference. And in case lesion, in case tract of gracilis and cunctatus, lesion are ipsilateral, and in case anterior and lateral spinothalamic tract, lesions are contralateral. So this is all about tract of gracilis and cunctatus. If you like this video, please press the like button and please subscribe my channel.